Hi guys, my name is Jay Gannon and I create weekly videos helping you to elevate your LinkedIn content strategy. I'm so excited about the video today. I'm gonna literally show you the tool that changed the game for me. Now I create content almost every single day on LinkedIn. I post Monday to Friday and I've been doing that for months now. Before, I always struggled with content creation. I loved it, but I can never ever achieve consistency, and I'm sure that is something that a lot of us have felt. I'm gonna show you exactly how I turned an idea into LinkedIn content. And as you will see, I've literally transitioned my whole life onto Notion. I used to use Trello as a productivity tool, but now I use Notion for everything. I've got my gym timetable in there, I've got my to-do list, and I turn that into a next action list, which I can talk about in another video. And most importantly, I use it for my LinkedIn content strategy. Consistency is so important, and using Notion has helped me to really maintain the quality of my posts while increasing and ramping up the quantity. If you haven't used it already, Notion is an all-in-one workplace tool. And I think that's a really good title because, like I said, you can use it for pretty much anything. It's a really good way to have a system that works for you. So let's jump into Notion and I'll show you my LinkedIn content calendar and how I use it every single day to create content. In the description box, I'm also gonna include the exact template that I'm using. You can use that template for your own content creation. I wanna make it as easy as possible for you guys. So please do keep giving me feedback. If you like this video, tell me. If you dislike it, dislike the video. And in the comment section, I want to hear your ideas. I think I'm on like 71 subscribers, so I'm quite close to 100. So please share this video with anyone you think would be useful to. And if you're not already subscribed, come on, hit that subscribe button. So guys, this is Notion. As you can see on the left-hand side, I use Notion for so many different things. I've got something called Life Navigation, which includes how I journal and how I have a weekly review. Like above here, I've inserted this as a comment, which is like my morning routine. Previously, this was just like a bit of paper in my room and I never even looked at it in my room. It's actually remarkable how we don't even look at the things that we create. We don't look at the ideas that we have. We don't spend the time to actually review the information. A weekly review, which I can do a video about in the future, has really, really helped me to create content. So typically every Sunday, I'll spend about 2 to 3 hours and I try and create content at least 2 weeks in advance. And throughout this video, I'm gonna show you why that really does work for me. So if we jump into my LinkedIn section of Notion, we've got different categories. I've got my content plan, which is what we're going to work in today. And I've also got different resources, my personal brand content, different information about my personal brand, like for example, the branded orange that I use, the fonts and all my different assets. I've also got Shield Analytics, which I'll tag in the description box, which is the best way currently to get statistics for your LinkedIn profile. Shield's a really, really good tool. I've also got lists of compiling the different LinkedIn tools and resources that I've come across. So for example, if you liked this video, you could add this into resource and you can always kind of jump back into that video as and when. We're going to jump straight into my content plan. What I love about Notion, it's so customizable. You can add covers and have discussions. And right here, I use this to remind myself of why I'm creating content. I typically create content on LinkedIn around the themes of psychology and social media. I've been working in social media strategy for a long time, but on LinkedIn, I like to think about how people behave. So when it comes to content creation, it's really important that you niche down. So you start to have a couple of topics which you really start to own. And once you become known for those topics, you build up an engaged audience. Then you can start to tackle more broader topics. Now, from my own experience, I've really learned that it's so important to have a process, to divide the tasks that you need to do into batches. We all have ideas. We all have ideas for content. Ideas can come to us at any point of the day on any given day, usually when you're not expecting an idea. So my first rule to have is to have an idea section, a board, whether it's a Notion board or the notes app on your phone, somewhere you can track all of your ideas. Now, as you can see, this is why I've got over 150 ideas for LinkedIn content. Now you might typically think, well, how is that even possible? But this is things I've curated from the internet, like blog articles, and it's ideas I've had throughout the week. This is how I work with my LinkedIn content schedule. So I'll start with an idea. So here I've got all content falls under three main categories: education, inspiration, and entertainment. So I heard this on a YouTube video, and it was a really nice summary of how content falls under typically three pillars. So you might watch something for education, like this video. You might look at something for inspiration. For example, learning how to play the piano could inspire you. Or entertainment, so you think about like TikTok videos. Put your idea here into Notion. You can set it as a status. You can do anything which will help your workflow. If you're working in a team, you can assign different members of your team. And you can set a date. So for example, if I set today's date, and then we went into our content calendar view, you'll now see that the content falls under here. And what I like to typically do is write a comment to myself about that idea, and you can customize the text. You can turn it into anything like bullet points. You can literally start to write your post out into Notion. Now what I would then do is, as that turns into a first first draft of a post. When I've gone into the post and I've started to write different things about it, I would put it into my draft column. Now, what I like to do is to do different tasks when I feel in the mood to do different things. We've all come across writer's block. Sometimes you're not in the mood for writing. So what you could do instead is you could just have 5 to 10 ideas that you turn into a first draft of a post, which basically means you've just got your first ideas down about that post. Then we can move that content when it's a first draft into ready to post after optimizing it for LinkedIn. So for example, that is adding emojis, that's doing the copywriting, having an engaging headline, and I'll show you more of these sort of posts in a second. And then when you've posted that content onto LinkedIn, you'd move it onto posted. Now you might be wondering, why have a list of all the content you've posted? You've already put that time in, so why not repurpose that in the future? If you're growing your LinkedIn channel as you hope to, or your company page, you're gonna wanna be able to revisit the content you've created. Because in 6 months' time, your current followers might not have seen that post before. Also, you can turn those ideas into more long-form articles to go onto LinkedIn articles. You can make blog articles for your website, or you can look at your previous ideas when you're low on ideas for inspiration. So that's how I use Notion to create LinkedIn content. Now, I want to show you the different steps. So what does an idea look like? So if we go on to the different ideas I've got here. So this was a quote I heard once, and it said, "Usain Bolt's coach doesn't run as fast as him." Now that really inspired me because it shows about accountability and how we can have coaches or mentors or other people who can really help us. And I came across that quote and quite frankly just wanted to share it with people on LinkedIn, and that's gonna be a future post. Yeah, I also use Medium. I look at different sort of content for business, entrepreneurship, personal development, productivity, and every single week I get an email showing me different content about those sort of topics. You can use the web clipper on Notion to pull those articles through. So let me give you an example. So using mantras to build powerful mental strength, and Notion has pulled through the exact article URL, which is really helpful. And as you can see, the exact text has been pulled through. And this is all copy and pasteable. I can edit it. So this could be a really good way to kind of create lots of different ideas. So I really don't believe that you guys can run out of ideas or not have ideas to post. There's so many things out there that you guys can talk about to create LinkedIn content about and share it with your audience. So to give you an example of what I call a draft post, a post that's in its first draft. So for example, we've got one here called Don't Break the Chain Apps. Now, Thomas Frank is a productivity YouTuber, and he was talking about different apps that he uses to get a habit going, and he calls it Don't Break the Chain. On a comment here, so this was actually in January. So for example, I would have forgotten this idea if I hadn't kept track of it. I've got here that there's certain hard ways you can keep a habit going. So you can incorporate, for example, consequences. For example, telling your friend, "I'm gonna go to the gym, and if I don't go, I'll give you 20 quid. Or the fact you're paying for a gym membership, that's a hard way to keep a habit going because you feel like you're losing money, obviously, if you don't go. Now, as you can see here, this post isn't quite yet finished, which is why it's the first draft. So I've listed 3 different Don't Break the Chain apps about habits, and I haven't actually done the third one. But when that's done, I'll start to make it look like something which resembles more like a LinkedIn post, and that would be moved into my ready to post column. So we would just drag it into here when it was ready to post. I'll show you now what a ready to post post looks like. Got here, how to handle self-sabotage. So this is one of my favorite psychology topics. And because I had the initial idea in a draft, when I was in the mood to write, I was actually able to kind of think about books that I've read. And actually this week I was reading a book called The War of Art, and it goes into self-sabotage. Take some time to think about what's the best way of getting this content to the user. Now a post, which is ready to post, is called Be Ultra Clear on the Next Physical Actions. Now a great thing to do in the first line is to ask a question. So I've said, how many times have you felt frustrated that you weren't able to start a task? Now that's quite relatable. So I've, instead of just saying to people like, "Oh, I felt frustrated yesterday, wasn't able to start a task," and that was the post. That's more like the idea of the post. Now you've jumped in, you've actually taken some time to create it and form a post which is gonna get your audience talking. Hopefully that will get comments and you can start to show your personality and it can fit under your content themes. Now I can do lots of videos about content themes, how to talk about your brand narrative and build up your personal brand. So what I would do here, I would copy and paste it and I'd probably put it into Google Calendar so I can access this content on my phone and I can post it onto LinkedIn when I'm ready. So that's normally in the mornings where I post. Or you can get the Notion app and you'd be able to just copy and paste this straight into LinkedIn. And then once it's posted, I would move it into the posted column. The truth is you've already put the time into this content to create it and you can repurpose it in the future. A really important reason to increase the quantity of your post is that not everyone is gonna see every post you do. For example, Gary Vaynerchuk posts probably 10 times a day on all these different platforms and you don't see all of his posts. Also, it's great practice to repurpose what you've created. So if you created a text post on one thing, perhaps that could be the script for a video. Or you could continue from an idea and make a long form LinkedIn article, which can go on your profile and really establish your authority on a topic. So I hope that from seeing this, you can see how you can turn an initial idea into a first draft of a post And then when you feel inspired to write content, you can put it into ready to post and keep a track of all the content that you're posting. Now, as I said in the start of this video, I always try and plan at least 2 weeks of content in advance. So typically in my day to day, it works for me to do this on a Sunday. As you can see, I've got around 150 ideas. I've got 11 posts, which are kind of first drafts, and I've got 7 posts that are ready to post. Now, if you have 6 to 7 bits of content that are ready to post, and you want to post content on LinkedIn 3 times a week, that means you have 2 weeks of content planned in advance. We all know life gets in the way, and when life gets busy, you don't want to have to think, it's Tuesday, I need to plan content for Wednesday. Or worse, be planning your content on Wednesday to post on Wednesday, on Thursday, be planning your content to post on Thursday, and just doing things in an ad hoc fashion. This streamlined approach is going to save you time, you're going to be posting more content, and you're going to be consistent. And consistency is really everything. Whatever you're trying to achieve from posting more content, you're going to be pulling opportunities towards you if you're visible. Now, a misconception is that if someone's posting content every day, that means they're making content every day. But you need to treat it like a business. You have to think ahead, plan ahead, and then you can distribute that content out. It's a really good feeling that when you spend 2 to 3 hours focusing on your system, creating content, to know that all you need to do is copy and paste that text or that video or that image onto LinkedIn at the optimal time to post. I promise you, from using a system like this to create consistent content on LinkedIn, you're gonna see so many results. You're gonna spend less time, produce more, and you're gonna enjoy the process a lot more. I really do recommend that you use Notion. If you don't already have an account on Notion, in the description box, I'll include my referral link, which will give you some credit off if you do want to go on a paid plan in the future. Just stick to the free plan and go from there. If you found this video useful, please do give it a thumbs up. I really want your feedback, guys. I want to be creating the videos that you want to see. If you want more videos talking about the strategy behind content, more videos about Notion, more tutorials, just let me know in the comment section. And of course, let's all connect with each other on LinkedIn. Drop your profile links in the comments and we can all follow each other. And don't forget, in the description box, I've included the exact template that you've seen here, which you can use for your own content creation. So you just create a Notion account and you can download that straight away. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope I can provide you value about LinkedIn content strategy. Be sure to take a look at the other videos I have on my channel, and please do hit that subscribe button, and also click on the bell to get notifications for when I create new content.